the name of Allah, the gracious, the most merciful. Very, very good morning, students. Today, we will discuss about patterns of sex determination. There are wide variety of patterns of sex determination in various individuals. The more common types of sex determining mechanisms are of three types. Number one, XOXX type. Number two, XYXX type. Number three, ZZZW type. These are three common types of sex determination patterns. Now, we will discuss the first type of pattern of sex determination. This XOXX type pattern is found in grasshopper, and protanner bugs. In this mechanism, XO individuals are male individuals, and XX type are the female individuals. In this pattern, male and female have different types of gametes which they produce. Firstly, we will discuss the heterogametic male mechanism in the grasshoppers. Heterogametic male, which is the XO. Male individuals have two types of supons because they contain only one X chromosome. Second sex chromosome is absent in the male grasshoppers and protanner bugs, and so they produce two types of gametes, two types of the supons. And females have two types of X chromosomes. Sorry, two X chromosomes. They have XX type. And so, female produces the same kinds of X. And so, supons are the cells. Supons are the haploid cells which determine the kind of the offspring. So, when we talk about heterogametic male in male grasshoppers and protanner bugs, one gamete contains X chromosome and second type of gamete contain no chromosome, contains no sex chromosomes. We can say that the second type of sperm is without sex chromosome. Without sex chromosome. See, in this case, this is XO male. When it produces gametes, two types of gametes are found. One gamete has X chromosome and the second gamete have no any sex chromosome, and this type of gamete which have no any X chromosome, it is known as the neulogamete. This is the neulogamete. And this gamete contains one X chromosome. Female offspring have XX type mechanism. Both the sex chromosomes are present in the eggs in the female. Same types of the eggs are produced by the female individuals. All the eggs contain X chromosome. Now we discuss the homogametic female, because both the chromosomes are of same type, and so eggs which are produced by the female individual are of same type, and so females are homogametic. Now we discuss the homogametic female. Homogametic female. That is XX type. Both the sex chromosomes are present in the female individuals, in the female grasshoppers, are protonal buds. Same types of gametes are produced. Same type of eggs are produced by female individuals because all eggs contain X chromosome. See, in this case, XX type female, it produces same types of gametes. All the gametes, all the eggs contain X chromosomes. These are the gametes, female gametes, eggs. All the eggs are of same type. It is the kind of sperm which determine the sex of the individual. Kind of sperm. Which is the sex determinant? Which is the sex determinant? And sperm determines the sex of the individuals. Sex of the offsprings depends upon the kind of sperm. Sex of the offspring depends upon kind of sperm. Kind of sperm that fertilizes the egg. Fertilizes the egg. If an X-carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, XX female offsprings are produced. If X carrying sperms, if X carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, XX type of offspring, female offspring, which is the female offspring is produced. And if the X carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, if the sperm which has no any X chromosome, if the neulosperm fertilizes the egg, XO male offspring is produced. If neulosperm which has no any sex chromosome, if neulosperm fertilizes the egg, XO type of XO male offsprings are produced. XO male offsprings is produced. In this way, we can say that it is the kind of sperm which determine the sex of the individual, because male individuals are heterogametic. They produce two kinds of sperms, and so the nature of the offspring, the sex of the offspring, depends upon the kind of the offspring. See in the figure. XX female, XO male, P1, this is the P1, gametes, female produces same types of eggs. All the eggs contain X chromosome, and male offspring produce the two types of sperms. Half sperm contains X chromosome, and other half sperms contain no any sex chromosome. When X type of sperm fertilizes the egg, it will produce female offspring. When neurosperm fertilizes the egg, when the sperm which contains no any sex chromosome, if it fertilizes with the egg, male offsprings are produced. These are the offsprings: female offspring and male offspring. From this, we get the result that the sex of the offsprings depends upon the kind of sperm. The sperm determines the nature of the individuals, whether it is female offspring or it is the male offspring. And so we can say that the type of the sperm is basically the sex determinant. Thank you very much.